geometry in elementary school tends to be a lot about just shapes. Well, I'm Christina Tondevold, the Recovering Traditionalist, and I hope you'll stick around as we take a look at geometry for elementary students beyond just shapes in our quest to build our math minds so we can build the math minds of our students. Now, the first thing I want to direct your attention to is the VanHeil Levels. I may be saying that wrong. It may be Heil. Correct me if I'm wrong. I'm trying to say Heil. But these levels is the main research that we have around geometry. And there's a lot of people who don't know about them. I'm going to give you a little brief overview, but I'll put a link below here to a great site by Enrich that you can go to get a little bit more info about these levels. But basically, kids in elementary school are typically in levels 0 and 1, and some a little bit in 2 in the upper grades of elementary. But the research of VanHeil, and this was a husband-wife research team who found these. So their research showed that a level 0 is known as visualization. This is where kids see visuals and it looks like something. So this is where you see kids who will say that a ball is a circle because it looks like a circle, right? They aren't looking at attributes, knowing that it's three-dimensional and that makes it a different shape. They just say it looks like whatever. An ice cream cone looks like a triangle to them, right? Because of the shape. It's got a point, and that's all that they're noticing. A level 1 is when they start to get into analysis, or what's known as description. This is where kids will start to notice some properties about something, and they use those properties, but they aren't starting to see connections between properties. So like they might notice and say how a square is a square because it has all the same sides, but they don't know how a square is connected to a rectangle, right? They don't see those connections. That starts to happen in level 2, where they are able to use properties, they're able to justify thinking about shapes, they're able to analyze a little bit and kind of get informal proofs. This is also the stage that's known as informal deduction. Okay? And that's about where elementary kiddos stop. There's levels 3 and 4 as kids progress through their understanding of geometry into middle school, high school, and beyond. And this is where kids start giving formal proofs. They start doing very abstract geometry. We're not going to go into those levels here, but I wanted you to understand those 3 levels that most of your students will progress throughout elementary school. And so we tend to focus a lot on shapes because that's a lot of the description that happens in those VanHeil levels. But I want to give you 3 things that will help kids progress through those VanHeil levels that aren't necessarily about describing and identifying shapes. Our first one is to use lots and lots of visuals. Now, in geometry is very visual. And I was a kid growing up that I did wonderful in mathematics until I was in high school and did geometry. And it was because it was so visual and I had to prove things. And to me, I was like, just give me the procedure and tell me how to do it. I wanted the abstract numbers and the equations to do. I wasn't used to doing visual things. Yet there were other groups of kids who struggled in mathematics, but then they finally flourished when they got into geometry because it was so visual. So the first recommendation is to include lots of visuals that aren't just shapes. You guys hear a lot from me around number sense about how we need to build a sense of numbers, that 3 isn't just the digit 3, it is 3 things. And giving kids those visuals in all areas of mathematics will help kids as they're developing that level 0 and moving into level 1. Now, a thing that will help with level 1 is our second recommendation here, which is to let kids draw, not just in geometry, but in all of mathematics. You guys know I'm a big fan of the CRA model, which is concrete, representational to abstract. Kids need to start out with concrete manipulatives, but oftentimes we jump from those concrete manipulatives to the abstract symbol. So they're seeing 3 and then we're attaching the digit 3 to it. The in-between phase is a representation. They need to draw three things or draw a model of three. Because we all know there's a whole lot that goes into drawing something versus just seeing it and saying, oh yeah, that's three. When you have to sit there and draw three squares or three rectangles, something is starting to build in that kid about what they start to notice about shapes that they don't do if they just see three cubes. Okay, so get kids to draw, and that will help kids in that level one. All right, my third recommendation is to get kids explaining their thinking and proving their thoughts. Like, why is this correct? It's not just geometry, but if they figured out 7 + 8 = 15, having them explain it and prove their thinking isn't just like, a lot of people think that we're just doing it to be mean. Like, if they just know it, just let them say, I just know it's 15. And there comes a point that, yes, we just let kids say 7 + 8 = 15. But having them explain their thinking starts building other ideas. It's not just about getting to the answer. Remember that. It's not just about creating calculators. It's about building their math minds and getting kids explaining their thinking and justifying why they're right versus someone else is not just about building their math minds, guys. It's about just common things that we need kids to be able to do in life, right? Not just proving why they're right about an answer in mathematics, but proving why they think this is correct out there in life. It's a habit that we want to help develop in all aspects of our children. But mathematics, when we do it in there, it also helps start to build them into level two and get them to start having informal deductions. So you can focus on shapes in geometry, but I want to encourage you to provide lots of visuals outside of shapes and geometry. Get kids drawing and get them explaining and proving their thinking. All of that goes into helping your kiddos progress through the VanHeil levels and build their geometric thinking. All right, I hope that this helped you build your math mind so you can go build those math minds and not just create calculators. Have a great day.